Welcome to War India News Hour. Customer experience is the top focus for CIOs. New research revealed that CIOs sit at the center of virtually every major business initiative in today's digital-first economy, with businesses tapping CIOs to digitally transform their organizations and help shape their return-to-work plans. It found that 98% of Indian CIOs, compared to 92% in the US, 83% in EMEA and 94% in APAC, reported an increase in their responsibilities. While customer experience is a top focus for CIOs, the new work-from-anywhere environment has evolved CIOs' priorities to be first and foremost employees and then customers. Today, CIOs are leveraging external customer journey management practices and applying those same principles internally to enhance their own employees' experiences. In just a year, we all went from a world with digital capabilities to a digital-first economy, which placed immense pressure on many leaders, including CIOs, many of whom were tasked with taking on a range of new responsibilities. Besides the pressure to accelerate their organization's digital transformation at record pace, they have to embrace their expanded role and influence as an opportunity to drive progressive digital-first programs and further collaborate with other business leaders to succeed in today's new digital-first reality. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. Juhi Chawla files plea in Delhi High Court against 5G technology. Actress Juhi Chawla has approached the Delhi High Court against the setting up of 5G wireless networks in the country, raising issues related to the radiation impact on citizens, animals, flora and fauna. Justice C. Harishankar, before whom the matter came up for hearing, transferred the suit to another bench for hearing on June 2nd. She further said these 5G plans threatened to provoke serious, irreversible effects on humans and permanent damage to all of the Earth's ecosystems. Cowin does not collect any information about COVID-19 infection history, says government. The Union Health Ministry on Monday said that the Cowin platform does not collect any information about the COVID-19 infection history of any person and its only work is to manage vaccination drives in the country. Cowin has been built as a platform to manage vaccination in the country. Cowin enforces only those rules relating to gaps between two slots as announced by the center from time to time, it added. Almentor raises $6.5 million Series B round led by PARTech. Dubai-based video e-learning platform Almentor has raised $6.5 million in a Series B funding round led by PARTech with participation from Savari Ventures, Egypt Ventures and Sengo Capital. This brings the total investment raised by Almentor to date to $14.5 million. The platform was launched in 2016 to compensate for the lack of online learning content for Arabic speakers. Almentor leverages more than 80 enterprise partnerships across the Middle East and North Africa, that is MENA region, and has so far delivered over 2 million learning experiences. Delivery raises $277 million led by Fidelity ahead of its IPO. Gurugram-headquartered Delhivery, India's largest independent e-commerce logistics startup, has raised $277 million in what is expected to be the final funding round before the firm files for an IPO later this year. The latest round was led by Fidelity Investments and also saw participation from Singapore's Sovereign Wealth Fund GIC, Abu Dhabi-based Fund Chimera and UK's Baillie Gifford. Regulatory filing revealed. Delhivery, which was founded 10 years ago, is now valued at $3 billion. Hackers demand Rs. 2.19 crores for release of confidential data. A Navi Mumbai-based electronic surveillance startup has become the victim of the growing ransomware attack. According to the police, the company's confidential surveillance data, which was in their computer system, had been hacked and encrypted, and that the hackers were demanding Rs. 2.19 crores for its release. The hackers had also threatened to sell the data on the black market if the company did not pay up, police said. That's it for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. Stay tuned. Thank you.